It's just a dream I had ever since I was a kid. I have a long line of family history in the military through all different service. I have uncles who were in the Marine Corps. My grandfather was in the Navy, and I decided this was my time. I wanted to better myself, so that's why I joined.
You're glad to be home, and there's a part of you that still wants to be there. And then you come home, not the same as you left. You hear the things when you're there, hey, you're gonna transition slowly. And no, it's a lot longer than the word slowly. It's harder on your family, especially when you come home with the difficulties and the things that happen to you while you're there.
While you're in, everyone suffered the same, I guess. So they know what you've been through. You know, you can kind of communicate with them a little better. But then when you get out, you have a conversation with someone, and it's like because they haven't been through what you've been through, they don't really. It's almost like you're speaking a different language. You know, it's English, but since they haven't, they can't really relate to you. It's almost like they don't understand.
It was hard. It was like another war for me.
People ask me about employing veterans and how should we go about doing that. One of the things I often talk to employers about is trying to change the conversation. And I mean that in two different ways. In one way, in the military, and the military hires and then they train you. So they take, and I'm a Navy veteran, so they take a kid out of Nebraska or the inner city. They discover that this individual has whatever key attributes they want. They hire them, meaning they enlist them, and then they train them. And 18 months later, that individual is a fire control technician on a ship out in the middle of the Atlantic. And what I tell employers is that same person can do any one of your jobs. But what happens with employers is they have a philosophy of train, then hire. And so many veterans don't know what they should get trained on before they go for their job search. So what I encourage employers to do is hire them and then train them, and we can use and leverage the GI Bill and other benefits, and such that what I tell employers is you have very little skin in the game. All you have to do is hire them, and we will help pay for the expenses of whatever education or training they may need. The other interesting piece that I talk to employers about is changing the conversation. There's a lot of employers out there that want to think that they're doing something good by hiring veterans, that they're helping veterans. And my argument back to most employers is veterans, when they come to the workforce, they enrich your workforce. So rather than you helping the veteran, I like to think that veterans are helping the employer. It's a different way and a different mindset, but I think it's a powerful message.
I went on two and a half year deployment to Afghanistan, where I was a staff sergeant, which is a leadership role. I was a leader of a 9-man fire team.
I went from literally carrying a surfboard around in Indonesia, not a care in the world, to coming back and within a year being on a ship where I was standing watch 6 hours on, 6 hours off, plus doing my normal, job description duties, sleeping 2 to 3 hours a day for weeks on end. You learn how to just keep going, to do the job.
Signed up right around the time the first Gulf War started. and I signed up to work as a nuclear machinist mate.
Veterans are great leaders because of the amount of responsibility and everything they experience at such an early age. They don't go to a course and they, you know, listen to it and walk away, but they have to take the what they learned and they have to apply it. And they have to do it in a setting in which the responsibility is more than just money or missing a deadline or a goal. It is, in some situations, life and death.
They've been in high pressure situations where there's a lot on the line, and they've done it for a long period of time.
Honor, courage, and commitment, they're not just words. You know, they're things that you live by. And there's, when your actions are driven by things rooted like that, there's a lot of meaning to it.
They are adaptive, they're inclusive, they communicate well. And the military instills high character as far as honesty, integrity, you know, personal sacrifice, civic duty.
You can't lead well until you've learned to follow well. And I think most vets have learned that.
You know, in the military, there's so much that's out of your control. Your task could be, you know, doing one thing one day, and the next day, the mission has changed, and you're doing something else. So constantly adapting to change is something that I definitely learned in the military.
We've all been in the same place together, and we've all kind of been through that same testing, basically, that you kind of go through. Life testing, I call it.
Of all the service members that I keep in contact with, regardless of the industry that they've gone to or if they've stayed in public service, going, you know, police or firefighting, all of them have been successful in their new life. I mean, across the board. And not just, you know, transitioning, but also excelling in everything that they've gone about doing.
Oh, simple thing, where have you gone?